The opposition caucus resolved to keep away from the parliamentary sittings since last month until the government apologizes officially to the opposition for the alleged brutal arrest of opposition leaders and supporters. The opposition summarized their grievances in 6 points, including the demand for the 18 missing persons, targeting and victimizing Muslims, detention without trial, violation of human rights in fishing communities, shrinking civic space, and trial of civilians in the court-martial. FDC has also been part of a boycott. However, the party spokesperson, John Chikonyogo, has today disclosed that they are to reconsider their position on this matter. He noted that the boycott led by the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, seems to have lost direction.
I heard one MP today say, well, that's why in your position, we are going to continue. Are you going to continue up to the end of this term for 2.5 years? Aren't you going to get some disagreements amongst yourselves, you, after about 4 months from today?
Chikonyogo blamed Mpuuga for over-politicizing the matter.
So we expected our brothers, who are the leaders of the opposition, the government, to plan this boycott properly. You're going to the boycott. Remember, chess player, you just treat it in chess. How do you play the middle game, which we are in now? And what type of endgame do you expect at the end of this exercise? All those things, you do it before you start the game.
Tomorrow, the National Executive Committee of the FDC Party, led by the party president, Patrick Amoria Toboy, is expected to convene at the party headquarters to decide on their final fate over this matter, whether to continue with the boycott as FDC or to pull out. The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, recently sounded a strong warning to the protesting opposition MPs that she will not hesitate to put a ban on those leading the boycott. Story compiled by Juliet Namoya for the news.